Welcome to this week's episode of Brainstorm, where we give you a glimpse into the world of science for Saturday, March 8th, 2014. I'm the gentleman physicist, filling in for Jack this week. We begin with news from the world of material science. Only a few weeks ago, we talked about a breakthrough in artificial nanomuscles that showed incredible promise for small-scale robotics. Now, an international team led by UT Dallas has also created an impressive artificial muscle, but from an unlikely material. While the previously covered artificial muscles were made from a new kind of metal alloy with impressive phase change properties, the ones we're talking about today are made from, well, fishing line. If you're thinking it can't be that simple, you're right, it also incorporates sewing thread. As it turns out, the polymer in fishing line can also undergo some dramatic changes due to temperature change. By coiling strands of this polymer in certain ways, the researchers were able to create artificial muscles that either rotated, contracted, up to 50%, or expanded. To put that in perspective, human muscles only contract by about 20%, and these fishing line muscles can produce approximately 100 times the mechanical force of a human muscle per weight. The heat that powers these muscles can be provided by a chemical reaction, ambient changes in temperature, or by passing a current through a resistant material, such as metal-coated sewing threads. One application for this technology is small-scale movements, such as tools used in microsurgery and mechanical components of microfluidic devices. Scaling up, the researchers think this has incredible applications for robotics and strong but versatile exoskeletons. So apparently, everything we need to build Iron Man can be found in a random storage closet or hobby shop. Switching gears to a more serious story from the world of medicine, engineers over at MIT have developed a new type of vaccine that may allow for the prevention of diseases not possible before. To quickly review how vaccines work, you're essentially exposing the immune system to a molecule found in a pathogen or disease, in order to train your immune system to fight it before the fact. For certain diseases, this is extremely effective, especially when whole organisms can be used to trigger an immune response. Using only fragments or specific antigens to trigger an immune response is not usually as effective, but some pathogens are too complex or dangerous to use the entire thing. However, no matter the type of vaccine, all of the action really happens in the lymph nodes, which is home base for T cells and B cells. So they developed a way to deliver the antigen molecules directly to the lymph nodes. A blood protein called albumin naturally binds to fatty acids and delivers them to the lymph nodes. So they combined their active vaccine molecules with a fatty acid. In experiments with mice, they tested this technique using molecules from HIV, melanoma, and cervical cancer, all of which resulted in an extremely strong immune response, especially compared to molecules alone without the fatty acid. Obviously, much more research is needed, but this will hopefully expand the range of diseases that vaccines can be developed for. Our final story is an update from the world of chemistry. A collaboration between the Lawrence Berkeley and Argonne National Laboratory has resulted in a new catalyst for use in fuel cells and hydrogen production. As we have discussed before, the best catalyst for many electrochemical applications is platinum. Unfortunately, platinum is incredibly expensive and rare. Double unfortunately, many of the applications for this catalyst would improve environmentally friendly technologies. So a lot of research is going into materials that reduce or replace the platinum and other precious metals entirely. So these scientists started by examining nanoparticles made from a nickel-platinum alloy, but then took it one step further. They created dodecahedron particles and then eroded away the interior, leaving a nanoscale metallic wireframe structure. This both dramatically increased the surface area and decreased the amount of total materials used, including the valuable platinum. We won't bother you with all the technical details, but they ended up being extremely effective catalysts, exceeding the Department of Energy's goals for 2017 tenfold. And these hollowed-out nanoparticles can be modified with relative simplicity to either work in a fuel cell or in the electrolysis of hydrogen gas. The scientists hope to further develop this catalyst and begin implementing it in various technologies. Well, hope you enjoyed this episode. In reference to our first story, what random junk would you make an exoskeleton out of? Let us know your thoughts on that and all the stories in the comments.